Well, I just got my notification from LKQ Tampa. That's why I'm in the garage getting together my bag with all the tools that I'm taking. Just got a notification that a 2003 Escalade just arrived. And those have a lot of parts that I generally try to find. The LQ9, which is the 6-liter engine that came in those from 03 to 06, I believe. It's same as an LQ4 6-liter, but it has a flat top piston. And it could be mated to an all-wheel drive setup, and it could be, so some options right there. But also, since I have an H2 Hummer, some of the interior seats and things like that are the same. So this could be something that could yield some parts, and it's only been there for a couple of hours. So I'm filling up my bag with everything from an 8mm to a 17mm socket, probably deep well. I'm probably also gonna take 10, 15, and 20 Torx head screwdrivers. I'll take a 6-inch extension and 3/8 drive. I'll take the 3/8 drive ratchet, and I'll probably take a Phillips screwdriver and anything else I'll need. I'd probably just find it there or make something work. But as of right now, that's what I'm taking. I may take some shallows too in case I try to do something with a seat or something, but 8 to 17, 3/8 drive, 6-inch extension, 10 to 20, and Torx head screwdrivers. And my favorite tool my girlfriend has ever gotten me, ever. I'm gonna take this because I bought from Harbor Freight the little adapter that changes it from 3/8 drive to 1/4 drive, and man, it just, what a fantastic tool. So anyway, I'll see you out at LKQ. File this under something I never thought I would see in an LKQ. A 61 Ford Ranchero.
What the hell?
Six-cylinder, a later model six-cylinder. Oh, now that's crazy. That's just wild. As I suspected, this guy, lucky man right here, he showed up with the plan, got it done. LQ9 out of there. You know, I'm surprised, when did you see it? Like 2 or 3 hours ago?
Something like that, yeah.
Man.
I had a buddy that was here.
Oh, okay.
He gave me a call and I came.
So you were saying, I know for sure that these have flat top pistons, but you said this also has better rods. I didn't even know that.
Yeah, it's got a full floating rod.
Yeah.
Full floating wrist pin in this rod.
Yeah.
And a lot of people call them a Gen 4 rod, but they're not because they've been around since 2001 in the Cadillacs like this.
Yeah.
So.
Hell yeah. Well, good on you, man. You hustled, you got it done. That's a desirable engine to get right there.
Yeah.
Is this one of the all-wheel drive? Or is it? Yeah, it is. I see the little drive shaft.
Mine has an MP149 transfer case.
And that right there shows you, man. You get people who show up, they get it done. That one actually showed up, had the full drivetrain in it. But it's not a total loss because I'm going to continue wandering around here. We've got some other vehicles that may have some interesting stuff. Also, when he's done taking what he wants, I'm gonna go back and see what he's gonna do with the ECU and stuff like that. So I'm gonna wander around. See, we got one right there that may hold some interesting stuff. You never quite know what's gonna be in an Avalanche. It can be a 5.3, it can be a 6.0. It's hard to say. I'm going to, well, we don't see the label out here. Well, yeah, it is. Look on here, 5.3. Well, we'll continue looking.
You're in the arms of the angels, far away from here.
Won't you give to rescue torque converters?
You know, I have a friend who actually been a buddy for years. And I was asking him about a car a long time ago. Was it going to be a good one? Was the model prone to braking? What about longevity? And he said, you know, one thing you could do is go to the junkyard and see how much of them are dedicated to that body style in the junkyard. Made total sense. That's why I've hung back from a whole lot of different vehicles, a whole lot of different engines and stuff like that. Also why I've bought some other stuff. I'm gonna check back in on a car that I came down and looked at about a month ago. A convertible Firebird.
see how much stuff is left. It actually looks pretty complete still. This is it right here. It's a 2000. Still has that trunk lid that's convertible only for that car. Yeah, that's kind of wild. It also should be noted that, believe it or not, those scratches were not on the door or the quarter panel. So somebody did that after it was in the junkyard. People have strange ways of behaving in this world, huh? Let's continue walking. I have found myself in the land of POS Jeeps. I gotta move on past this area. There's a Saturn. Saturns and Buicks and Blazers, oh my! Grand Cherokee 300. I gotta get out of here. This is some scary stuff. Ooh. Really kind of surprised by how many of these Escalades have shown up here in just the last week or so. But as you can see by looking inside of them, there's a lot of desirable stuff. If you have a Silverado, Tahoe, whatever, that kind of stuff, these seats swap into a whole lot of those. It's also the same as a Hummer H2. TVs in the back of the armrest, or the headrest. Got in here. Eh, 5.3. It's really hard to say. Some of these will have 5.3s and other ones will have that 6.0. You know, sometimes you see vehicles out here with just the slightest bit of damage and you wonder how they got in here. And other times you see other things. Oof. Yeah, that's not good at all. Wow. And dear, look at that. It's got the sunroof on it. Oh, nice. Third row seat. Well, more of a fourth, actually. That's nice. Chop top right there. Good Lord. Safe to say this truck sustained some damage. Passenger side is now the driver's side. What the hell? Wait, the bed is over there. Good Lord. Look at that. Diesel. I don't know if people have been messing up avalanches this week or what, but there's another one right there. Now, I'm going to actually have to climb up on top of this thing to see what that... Move some stuff around here. See what we got there. And now, move this tire back this way. And I don't see the plate. That sucks.
Well, that right there is how you do not wind up getting an engine. I waited till after work. I went home. I made sure my dog was fed. I came back out and showed up at the junkyard just in time to see another guy yanking the engine out of that Escalade. It happens, man. It's an LQ9, the 6 liters, and LQ4 and LQ9 are desirable, and people show up to take them as soon as they can. He told me, first of all, he's always out here getting engines, and he told me that he was standing in the yard when he got the call about the engine, and he looked down the row and saw the truck just a few cars away from him. So it's kind of hard to beat somebody who not only is on top of their game, but they're standing right there. I mean, guy needs to buy a lottery ticket. Next time I come out though, I'll find something and I will get that thing. And also, arguably, it wasn't the best setup for me to come out and get that engine anyway. I'm in my Corvette. See, that's... I don't see me putting it in the back. I'd have to go home and get my truck and stuff. Anyway, thank you guys, and thanks for running out to the junkyard with me, LKQ in Tampa. And we'll come back out here soon. If you like these videos, make sure that you like and subscribe and send me huge briefcases full of money, because I could always use briefcases full of money. Or tacos. Like chicken tacos, shredded chicken tacos.